How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Bushitting and welcome back to Pamiya. Sorry for the delay last week. I had a insane weekend that kind of took me by surprise. It started earlier than expected, and then it just kept going. And I just, by the time I was able to actually get to recording, I realized I just needed to start on Monday. And then, of course, naturally, I had so many technical difficulties. Couldn't even do the Bubble Up video that was supposed to come out then. So it's been a chore. It's been a bit of a hurdle, but we're going to jump into it now because we are continuing this story between Natsumi and Ryo. Now, I don't know if we're going to be getting bonding activities with all of the characters per se, but regardless, I've been really enjoying this glimpse into like kind of the bond between Ryo and Natsumi and seeing how this can like grow and develop. So I guess like Ryo, I think of all the cast so far, Ryo was the one that like left the biggest impression on me. So I'm very excited to be jumping into his like perspective more and hopefully helping him find purpose that's beyond just like going through the motions, defending himself and all that. We had a lot of some scraps already, but I'd say things are looking for the up and up so far. So we'll just jump right back into things and see how things play out here. So let's buckle up and get going. Hey, Kikuchi Ryo, how are things today? Oh, hey, Natsumi. Me calling out to him appeared to have startled Kikuchi. Was he beaten by his mother again? I had to protect him. Let's go. I swore I'd use my powers as an adult to protect him. He was, after all, my personal hero. I mean, he's a pretty cool bro. I know a place near my house that sells some great cakes. They might have donuts, too. Would you like to... Gloves. Your gloves are dirty. Oh, you're right. They are. I didn't notice. Kikuchi Ryo glared at me. What were you doing before you came here? Who knows? I'm not sure myself. You're just dodging the question. Actually, no, he might not be, though. Made a grin and acted like it was nothing. More importantly, about that cake shop. I think Midori would like it a lot. Hey, your hands hurt. Let me treat the... There's no need. I'm fine. Natsumi? You don't have to worry about me. I didn't care what happened to my body. There was only one thing I wanted to protect. As long as you're happy, it's all good. Felt the dense red cloud gather behind me. Had Kikuchi Ryo noticed it? I'm going. Huh? Why? Doesn't matter. Just don't follow me. He was going to the back alley where I just warned those delinquents. If some of them were still around, they might attack him. Cuckoo! I reached for the back of his hand to stop him. Huh. But he pulled himself away like the startled cat. Okay? I'm not really sure exactly what's happened here. Sorry. Stop following me. Huh? Why would he make such a sad face? That's enough. Stop waiting for me outside school and stop walking after me. I couldn't do that. If I did, Mamiya would ruin everything. I'm not meeting you ever again. Why would he say something like that? He had no idea just how worried I was about him. This actually is really reminiscent of like when Mamiya interfered with people, how they would like suddenly on a dime do a 180 from what was happening and just turn away from it. You reek of blood. I know he's supposed to be dead, but there was a time when I thought that you might have been not to me. But now I know it's just me overthinking it. You're nothing like him. That sentence made the blood rush to my head. Next thing I knew, I was grabbing him by the shoulders. How am I different? How am I so different from Natsumi? I tightened my grip. You know what? Considering he's Natsumi, I get the fanatic here. Like, his reaction here would makes total sense in that regard. But he must look absolutely insane. Kikuchi Ryo didn't so much as blink, which only ended up fanning my aggression. My other hand coiled around his neck. What the fetch are you doing, Natsumi? My leather gloves dug into his soft, youthful skin. How? Kikuchi Ryo! Can't you figure it out on your own? What a shame. Kikuchi Ryo closed his eyes and used his free hand to punch me in the left cheek. It threw me off balance, but I was able to stay on my feet. Despite being held by the neck, he was moving like he always did. I had always seen him as a proud wolf, but this made him look like a reptile without any sense of pain. I feel like I finally accepted it. Natsumi is dead. He then turned around and left. The idea that I disappointed him devastated me. Why? I was just trying to protect you. Why can't you see that? I knew it!
Oh, did you get into another fight, Ryo?
Shut up. It's not nothing to do with you.
I do believe you did the right thing back there. Getting involved with him will only get you in trouble.
What makes you think that?
Well, he doesn't think much of violence at all.
Huh?
You saw the cold eyes of his, didn't you? That tongue sticking out from between his thin lips? It was the red of a person without a heart.
Don't act like you...
Oh, I do know.
Unfortunately, Mamiya kinda does. Oh no!
I am your dad, after all. The only one who understands you. Hey, Ryo.
Enough.
Aren't you tired? Don't you feel sad and empty? Let's stop this, okay? The funeral's over. There's no need for you to keep hurting yourself over it. You should dedicate your time to yourself.
I... Kakuchi, you damn... I... Looks like I really can't escape this side, no matter how hard I try. That guy. It was morning, a few days later. I was waiting for Kakuchi Ryo in front of his house. It's been a while. He tried to ignore my greeting, so I grabbed his arm. Let me go. I have no business with you.
You fought again, didn't you?
It doesn't concern you. It does. It doesn't. Yes, it does. I'm your fan. My what?
Your fan? So I want you to stop doing things that only bring you sadness.
I can't. I'm not the kind of person who deserves to have fans. I can't stop being violent. He spoke in a slow, measured tone, but his voice was trembling. Almost like he was confessing something he'd sworn to keep bottled up forever.
It's fine.
Huh?
It's fine if you're violent with me.
Huh? Yeah, I agree.
Huh? If you can't overcome your violent urges, just direct them at me instead.
Well, that's not a solution. I mean, granted, in his position, it might be, but boy, that doesn't sound very healthy. That makes no sense.
Why? If you get violent with me, no one will come to call to retaliate, unlike those delinquents.
That's true, but why do you have to be the one to get hurt?
Well, I do intend to fight back.
I cracked a smile. Kakuchi Ryo was at a loss for words.
I never said I'd be one-sided, did I?
You're completely out of your mind, you know that?
I'll take that as a compliment.
We then exchanged a good laugh. Okay? It was an unusual solution, well-suited for warped, bloody characters like us. The two of us walked through the Tokyo streets. Interesting. So are the others still being influenced by Mamiya? And have we given him an extra out now? Like, I thought it was over. Like, I thought it was done. Like, I kind of thought we just ultimately failed, but maybe we were able to, like, swing back around in time. After an intersection, we stopped, waited for the signal to change. Oh, wow, look at that. World full of worthless people. They spend their days in empty idleness. They exist, but they don't really live. And I'm one of them. I feel you, bro. Especially lately. I've had a lot of very big self disappointments, and it's been very hard to deal with. And so it's interesting because, like, I almost feel like I'm kind of going through my own, like, crisis that some of these characters have been going through. Not Ryo's, obviously. I'm more like Natsumi when it comes to fighting, but... all my life, I've only wanted to be able to do something that could contribute, you know? Make a difference. Even if it wasn't a measurable difference or a historical difference, I've always just wanted to be the kind of person who could be there in ways that are unique, that are, like, helpful and interesting and worth, you know, talking about and considering, and to feel like I have done nothing truly remarkable till now. And to realize that what I always considered strengths aren't really that much of strengths at all, and that I might have been wasting a lot of what I assumed was going to be, like, my life plan. I kind of... Mamiya might be the game I really need to play right now, actually. It might be filled with the messages I need to hear. So... I guess I'm glad I'm playing it right now. Thank goodness I don't have a Mamiya in my life. Oof. Anyway. Yeah, that's true. I'm just as worthless as you are. The same could be said for everyone else. We're all worthless. As the traffic light changed color, the people around us all began to move. The sound of their footsteps was almost grating. As people's lives intertwined, something in them would begin to get gradually chiseled down. An endless, precious, intimate something that we were all born with. Huh. The cold air made my wound above my eye sting. Does it hurt? Not really. Acting all tough won't make the pain go away. Like you're the one to talk. You know, I know you felt each and every one of my blows. Don't be ridiculous. The way you're speaking says otherwise. Look, I wasn't trying to get you to shut up. The red traffic lights that were so often would so often annoy me became gorgeous, glittering rubies when I squinted. We'd had a fight just now. We both went all out, ready to break the other's bones. Fetch. Banishing all but the faintest trace of common sense from our minds, we kept on pummeling each other until we both started spitting blood. Cool. Cool, I guess. I couldn't even tell if the pain was in my palm was from him punching me or from the impact of me hitting him. The pain Kikuchi Ryo gave me, and the pain I gave Kikuchi Ryo, they all melted into one within me. Man, this hurts like hell. Same here. The white breaths of air we exhaled dispersed between the high-rise buildings. I gently looked at Kikuchi Ryo's smiling face. In those eyes of his, I saw the ferocity we were all born with, something that's been with us for a millennia. Hey, Midori. Midori. Hello. Huh? When I called out to her, Kikuchi Midori quickly hid behind her brother. Oh, did I scare you? Don't worry, she's always like this. She acted differently last time we met, though. I suppose time and place do matter. There was more in her startled glances than just fear of strangers, and it made me feel a little uncomfortable. Here. Oh, right. Oh, man. You're pretty absurd yourself. Making an exasperated expression, Kikuchi Ryo reached into the first aid kit to take out some antiseptic gauze. Show it. Oh, okay. Take off your jacket. I can't treat you like this. All right. Yeah, we beat each other to a pulp and then heal each other. It's like the great circle of life. Once I lift up my shirt, Kikuchi Ryo had been covering my wounds in antiseptic. That hurts. Of course it does. It does. And yet... Kikuchi Ryo? I don't think I'm mistaken. Huh. You mean I can't be fixed unless you pull crazy stunts like this? That's not what I meant. I think your conviction that violence is bad is what's weighing you down. What are you trying to say? That violence is evil? You're not wrong, but it really depends on the situation. You can use it for self-defense as well, in which case it becomes a strength of sorts. And strength is what weak people like us need. After all, Natsumi was also saved by Kikuchiryo. I don't care what happens to me, as long as it helps lessen the guilt you feel whenever you resort to violence. Honestly, I don't really get what you're saying. Oh, okay. Look, I don't know if what you're doing comes naturally to you, if there's some kind of motive behind it, but making a person treat the wound they themselves caused is pretty messed up. He hung his head, but continued treating my wounds with experienced movements. There. Thank you. This late already, huh? I gotta make food, and you need to leave. Oh, maybe I could have... No. Just go already. Sorry. Despite the awkward goodbye, I felt like Kikuchiryo became more open with me after that day. Sure! Nothing like beating the crap out of each other to, like, get to know each other. There's no end to this! Come on, don't say that. The year's about to change, and we are making progress. We're close. Let's rest. We just did. You don't have any right to say that. Natsumi. yes? Can we go for a sponging? Sure. Guys, we'll go to the back alley for a bit. Sure. Okay. What's a sponging? Yeah, that sounds... Boom, blam, pow. It's like, hey, I need to punch somebody. Let's go. We're back. Yep. Why are you covered in bruises, Natsumi? What happened? Well, you know, this and that. Wait, Ryo's not looking too hot either. You think? Probably just imagining it. More importantly, what happened in the year 1787? The Tempo reforms. Oh, you're off. What happened that year was... What's a sponging? I don't like being the only one doing the punching. Build some mass. Huh? 99, 100, there. Now it's time for push-ups. We're still doing it? It's too early for a break. I'm already 23. More like still only 23. Now start push-ups. How many? I'll make you do this until you're able to punch me. There's no way. So yeah, our wholesome activities were going smoothly. Come on, 10 more push-ups. Do you want to get strong or not? Is it just me? Are you really into this? This reminds me of the days when I took training because I was so weak I couldn't even beat Minato. That actually happened to you? Listen, Natsumi, here's something you should know about my fan. Strength is everything. Okay. Boy, I'd be so bad at that lesson. He was so snooty and pitiful. My face is all relaxed. I wonder if the sponging is working on me too.
Ryo. Are you back?
Yeah.
Come over here for a bit.
Uh-oh. More blood. Why?
Ryo.
Mamiya.
Your mother punched you and now you're bleeding. How sad.
I...
It's fine. You have me. Even if everyone else in the world mistreats you, you'll always have me, your dad.
Was he calling himself dad last time? I don't think he was. Mamiya.
Relax. It's okay. I'll stay by your side just like you wanted me to.
It's become routine for me to wake up at the curtless in this curtless home. Time for some morning training again. Coach Kikuchi sure is strict. Well, at least I got to meet him every day. A little muscle pain's a shallow price to pay for that. Good morning, Kikuchi-ryo. Oh, hey, Natsumi. Good morning. You okay? You don't look too good. You're just imagining it. Oh, okay then. Training's canceled for the day. Huh? Yeah, I know. And I'm sorry. I'm just a little sleepy is all. Is your part-time job that tiring? It's not that. But it's also not something you need to worry about.
Kikuchi-ryo?
Look, I'm fine. Really. He made an oddly uncharacteristic smile. My eyes widened as a feeling of panic washed over me. It was Mamiya. It had to be. Little by little, Mamiya was chipping away at his heart, wearing it down. Why wouldn't he confide in me? Why would he rush willingly toward his own death? A red sky, heavy clouds. I felt like something heavy and inescapable was pressing down against my heart. Shall we go? I asked him that, but didn't say where. If he took my hand, I would do everything in my power to help him. I was certain he understood that. He passed through the withered trees. The fallen leaves crunched under his feet with a pleasant sound. Meanwhile, the settling sun stretched out our shadows, making them almost blend in with the trees. Let's do it. Huh? He held a single acorn in his hand. I found myself staring at its smooth surface and blatant symmetrical form. Were you looking for this? Is that why you've been quiet all this time? Got a problem with it? No, I just thought you might have started to hate me. Is that what you've been thinking about? Well, I mean... As I lowered my eyebrows, Kikuchi spent a few moments in thought before continuing. If it ever happens, I'll just say it. Huh? If you ever feel like I've started to hate you, I mean... And for the record, I don't hate you. I'll tell you straight up how I feel, so if you're ever worried, just ask. I don't want to be misunderstood. Especially by you. Thanks. When I smiled at him, he hastily averted his gaze. He was likely feeling a little bashful. Anyway, what's with the acorn? It's the prettiest one I could find. If Midori were here, she'd probably pick this one and give it to you. But why? His eyes widened in surprise at my question. He looked almost like a cat. Finding something you like will make you want to share it with someone else. It's not my opinion, by the way. It's just what I think Midori would do. Right. Midori's presence always helps me. He hadn't taken my hand back then. I knew full well that he couldn't escape from that home. Midori always finds something wonderful in sceneries I tend to just ignore, including the ones in our gray, monotonous lives. With Midori, anything can become a treasure hunt. By looking at the world through Midori's eyes, I'm able to keep my pride as a person without giving up on life. So, it's okay. I know. Midori's a good girl. It's fine. I do understand that. I see. That's fine, then. Yeah. I wasn't able to pick up on what he was thinking just then. He was two steps behind me. Keeping the same distance, he silently followed me from behind. Suddenly, I turned to face him. He was looking right at me, just as he had until now. I hoped he would be going forward. The northern wind passed bashed between us. The sun was dazzlingly bright. His short, wavy locks danced gracefully in the wind. We about to have a moment here? Like a charged moment? Kikuchi-ryo. Smooth orange eyes. Natsumi. I don't care how silly I've become. Same here. None of it matters as long as you're by my side. Shut up. I know how gentle you are, heart. Thanks. We then rode a train and amusement to an amusement park. I figured Kikuchi Ryo would enjoy being here. I didn't know why, but the place felt older and more deserted than it had in the writings. Two guys in an amusement park. You like them, don't you? I never said I did. You don't have to. I can tell. Come on. Let's get on the swings. Wait, why are you holding my hand? I mean, I can't let you stray from me now, can I? Okay, yeah. This is a date. I don't care what you say. This is just definitely a date. I thought there wasn't going to be any romance in this story, but maybe there is. Is that a reason enough? Come on, it's fine. We're the only ones here. I grasped his bony hand. This wasn't something as sweet as a bond between lovers. It was more like gently holding a child so that he doesn't drift away and get lost. You don't have to be an older brother today. I'm 23. That makes me 6 years older than you, so feel free to rely on me, alright? I turned to give him a smile. And his cheeks flushed red. He gingerly clasped my hand. Okay, maybe it's just brotherly, but still. I was surprised by how little resistance he displayed. There. Let's go there next. Let's do the free fall again. It's just, how many more times are we gonna do this? With us being the only ones here, we could go on as many rides as we wanted. Still. Kikuchi Ryo, we're riding way too many screamers. That's because I like them. You didn't strike me as the type that would. Well, I couldn't exactly ride them with Midori around, you know? Oh, I suppose that's true. You're the one who said I didn't have to be the older brother now. That's why I'm letting you spoil me. Right. Huh. Did that mean things were actually going well? A little too well. Kikuchi Ryo's adorably honest nature helped me handle the free fall until the eighth time. After that, though, I can't take this anymore. Hey, are you okay? Yeah, at least I want to believe I am, but... Okay, stay put and rest here. I'll go get you something to drink. Thanks. Would that help, though? When I feel nauseous, the last thing I want to do is drink. I took off my coat and sat down on the bench, hoping it would alleviate some of the nausea. There's no one else here. It seems a bit more lively when I saw it in writing. Oh, a balloon. I started following it with my eyes. There was no way of knowing where a balloon would end up after it had been let go. It would simply vanish into the distant sky.
Yet you let go of Ryo's hand.
The voice from behind me sent a chill down my spine. A fierce gust of wind sent the balloon dancing through the air. Beyond them, I spotted an all-too-familiar figure. A yellow sky, a faintly glowed golden hue, a deserted amusement park, youth brimming with desire.
Welcome to my domain.
Mamiya.
An amusement park. How very thoughtful of you. It is, after all, a place filled with the dreams of children, a space seemingly cut off from the rest of the world. It's what Ryo truly wants, and only I can grant him what he desires.
You're wrong. The only thing you can grant him is death, and that's not what he wants.
Oh? And what do you really know about him? Do you have any idea what's become of his childlike innocence after it was pushed outside by pain and responsibility? Well, do you? Of course you don't. You merely felt like you did after reading his story.
Yeah, this guy. Oh, this is horrifying, but really, really cool at the same time. Well, yeah. It can be difficult to live with someone who's led a different life and hold different values. And it might indeed feel easier to just take your own imagination. That way you only ever hear what you want to hear. However, even with all its pain and hardship, I still believe that forming connections with other people is something to be cherished. If you were all alone in this world, you wouldn't have anyone to share your joys or worries with. You just end up getting crushed under the weight of your own emotions. The road may be fraught with obstacles, but I do think we must try to live side by side with our fellow men. That's just something you have to accept if you are to live in this world.
I see. We may eventually become nothing more than memory. We cannot betray those who need us. When they seek us out, we want to show them kindness. It's to make up for all the suffering they had to endure at the hands of those who possess physical bodies. If only I had my own body, I could make them so much happier.
Did you run off somewhere? Off to somewhere?
Not really. Wait, is it already this late?
I'd only just now realized that the sun had already set. Mom said she wouldn't come home today, so Midori should be fine.
In that case, why not stay over somewhere?
I don't have any money on hand, though.
Oh, please, don't underestimate the financial stability of adults.
Man, you're so... He made an exasperated sigh. Despite his best efforts to appear unaffected, Kikuchi Ryo could do little to hide his palpable excitement.
Excuse me, we missed the final bus for the day, and...
Not to worry, sir. We do have free rooms available. I'll be happy to show you to one. In the end, we decided to spend the night at a lodging house near the amusement park. Despite our sudden arrival, we managed to book a free room. Once inside, we realized how needlessly spacious it was for just the two of us. Wow, a tatami! I love these things. There's just something about them, you know? I could freaking use one. As I was excitedly scanning the room, the young man was sniffing around like a cat.
What's wrong? Do you smell something?
Oh, no. It's just a bit of a habit.
Okay. Did he perhaps enjoy the smell of tatami? When I mimicked him, he made a rather displeased expression.
Good night, then.
Yeah.
Good night.
We took two futons out of the closet and laid them down on the luxuriantly large floor. Kikuchi Ryo put over his shoulders. It didn't look like he was planning to run away. I'm sorry. I'm just thinking about it's making me sleepy. Once I was sure of that, I turned off the lights. I suddenly woke up. Going by the darkness, it was still night. Needing to go to the bathroom, I walked over to the sliding door and... Wait, what are you doing? I found Kikuchi Ryo standing outside. I'm standing guard.
We're not in some medieval fantasy show, you know?
Could it be that you had trouble falling asleep? Forget about me and answer.
The smell of this place is new to me. I can't sleep if I don't know the smell of a room. And since I couldn't sleep, I figured I might as well make myself useful. You paid for this place, and then I went and wasted it. I'm sorry.
Okay. Go on, get dressed. Let's take a walk outside.
The chilly air outside felt pleasant. It neatly caressed our cheeks with its cold fingers. The two of us continued inhaling, deep breaths in silence. What could be waiting for us beyond that hill? Did he know the answer to that? Kikuchi Ryo said nothing. He merely looked into the distance with those clear amber eyes of his, occasionally blinking when the wind tickled his eyelashes. What could be waiting for us beyond that hill?
Are you tired?
Not really.
I see.
We just kept walking. We had no idea what awaited us. It could have been a terrifying monster that would swallow both of us whole. Or it could have been a dark, endless, stretching desert. Regardless, we had no choice but to press on. We ate this warm soup that he bought at a vending machine we'd passed by. Relief washed over me in waves.
It's good.
Kikuchi Ryo was not saying anything, not nothing. But when I looked at him in the pale white breaths he exhaled, he did seem somewhat at peace. At school, he always reminded me of a caged bird. He'd do nothing but gaze out through the window. He had always been closer to both life and death than anyone else, and lived a pure life with no room for either entertainment or boredom. I'd always found that both intense
and a sign of strength. Oh, Kikuchi Ryo, look!
A star shone brightly up in the sky, almost as if it competed to compete with the dark clouds.
Oh, there's the thumbnail. There's the thumbnail. I've had a good selection of them for this episode, but man, that's a thumbnail.
You shine as fiercely as the first stars in the sky.
You don't blend in with the other stars, though. You're too dazzling for that. You burn as bright and strong as your life allows. And that's why I know that you're going to be able to bear whatever burdens you're carrying right now.
You're strong. And you know the makings of a proud, resolute heart. But there's something I want you to always remember. You're never alone. It might be difficult for you to say it to someone like me, though. Especially considering the idea that you hold yourself to. But mankind is more fragile than anyone realizes. If you feel like you're about to buckle under the pressure, share your pain with someone else. Let them in. They won't be bothered. So have the courage to rely on others. I know it might be difficult at first, but there's no reason to worry. People are more accepting than you think. And why is it so bad if they're not? Your moments of weakness, as well as your uglier sides, they're just as much a part of you as your strength or tenacity. They all make up who you are. So don't let your ideals crush you.
Maybe that's part of the problem I'm going to have facing. Maybe my ideals are crushing me. I'm crushing myself underneath my own expectations and the lack of follow-through. But the trouble is, like, when it comes to me and currently what I'm going through, I'm not sure how I can rely on others. I mean, I already have people in my life that I talk to, I seek advice from, and, you know, I want to make sure I stay as balanced as possible, but I still feel like I'm reeling. Despite having the support, despite having people around me. But I still feel like I'm being crushed in a lot of ways. And when you open up about your pain to someone, make sure to accept their sadness when they share their grief with you. It might not happen right then and there, but sometime later down the road, and you might feel a little awkward about it, but don't forget your own pain. Treasure yourself and those around you. I want you to be thankful for the miracle of being born into this world.
I see. I didn't know if he was able to sleep peacefully back at the lodging house. Even so, as I waited for the morning sun, I hoped that he was at least a little bit at ease. Sadly, the path leading home from the lodging house was darkened by cloudy skies.
Here.
What is this?
A balloon, as you can clearly see.
I'll take it.
Oh?
What?
I'm surprised by how honest you're being.
I've always wanted one. I knew it would get in the way, but I've always wanted to grab a balloon on my way home from the amusement park.
I see. Ryo, I'm simply where your happiness is. All I wanted was to be your dad. Have a balloon. It's a little something to protect you on your way back home. It may end up deflating by tomorrow, but it will protect the child in you until you get home. Treasure it and make sure it doesn't fly away.
Goodbye, Mamiya. Goodbye. Kikuchi Ryo didn't turn around. Fourth Friday. Okay. All right. Can I save here? All right. That is very clearly a good spot for us to end. So I think we're going to stop there. I wonder if now I'm going to be able to work on like a one-on-one relationship with somebody else.
maybe Rio's finally been able to overcome and say goodbye to Mamiya. And if that's the case, then maybe I can work with somebody. I'm going to work with each of them one-on-one and kind of go through all these motions, which sounds like a really appealing way to end this story. Wouldn't that be kind of fun to be able to get these singular moments together? So I'm looking forward to that, but I think this is the perfect place for us to end. It's a little bit of a shorter episode than I've done before, but I've also been, I think I'm dancing with a cold right now, so my throat's getting sore. So this was actually just perfect in so many ways. But yeah, if it hasn't been pretty obvious, I've got a lot of stuff going on right now, and I've been kind of battling my own headspace a lot. So in a way, this journey with Rio was really, really good for me right now. I don't think it's going to directly help at all, but maybe I can take some Natsumi's advice and really kind of ponder and think about like how I'm approaching problems, and maybe understand that it's okay to be not everything I feel like I should be. Crushed by my ideals. That's something it's never occurred to me before. Maybe that was what I needed to hear tonight. So it's a bit of an odd one because normally I don't wax so poetic, but like I really think that this time in my life, I actually kind of needed that a lot. And so I'm going to go think about it because it's going to be a lot to digest. But thanks for sharing this journey with me. I hope that things are going to continue looking good for you. Hopefully this was a good episode for you as well. What were your thoughts on some of the discussions? What do you think about Natsumi's approach with trying to handle Rio and trying to kind of thwart the influence of Mamiya? Do you think it's actually worked? Don't spoil anything if you already know, but like, I think there's a good chance that it has worked, at least in a way that's like going to be potentially lasting. So I'm really excited to see how this all plays out. Thank you to the patrons who helped select this content for the channel specifically. Like, you guys picked a really good one. Hope you're enjoying it as much as I am, and I look forward to being able to select future content with you as well. If you're interested in becoming a patron and being able to have some back behind the scenes influence on the channel and having the ability to kind of help me cultivate the list of visual novels that I want to play in the near future, like, check out the link in the description. It's a good place to go. You get access to some Discord stuff too, so you can more easily chat with me and ask me questions. But I look forward to chat with every one of you. Thank you so much for spending your time here, watching and doing everything you do with interacting with me. I appreciate every second of it. So thank you so much. Have a great day, and until next video watch me, I'll see you next. See you there.